I'm Anantha Chandrakasan, MIT's provost and the head of the MIT Generative AI Impact Consortium. It's an absolute pleasure to welcome you to the inaugural symposium of the MIT AI Impact Consortium, or MAGIC. The energy in this room reflects the enormous interest in the topic of generative AI and MIT's ability to drive progress through collaboration. There's been a tremendous amount of interest and work in industry and in academia in creating large language models and its broad-based applications. This consortium is focused on the impact of generative AI across domains such as manufacturing, life sciences, transportation, design, energy, and so on. To maximize impact, we need to bring researchers across research domains. MIT is uniquely positioned to catalyze that convergence, bringing together researchers from across the institute to work across domains and also to work with our industry collaborators. I want to thank the founding members of our Industrial Advisory Board, Analog Devices, Coca-Cola, Intersystems, OpenAI, SK Telecom, Tata Group, and TWG Global for stepping forward as partners in this work. I would also like to thank McKinsey for providing deep insights and advice to the IAB. The deep commitment of the founding members reflects a shared belief that bold research done in the open can shape a better future. Thanks to their support, we're able to fund more than 60 interdisciplinary projects on campus. This consortium is more than a platform for research. It's a model of how we engage industry, energize faculty, empower students, and deliver impact all at once. And it is a commitment to our openness. So I was really impressed that these companies signed up knowing that all of the work that we do is going to be open source. The work will not just benefit just the member companies, but society at large. And that's why the solutions that will be emerging will be open source, interdisciplinary, and designed for public good. And today's program gives you a glimpse of what is already happening and what is coming next. You will hear from MIT faculty at the forefront of research, from innovators shaping the future of entrepreneurship, and from students whose work reminds us the next generation is not just ready to lead, in many ways, they already are doing so. This is a pivotal moment. Generative AI is moving fast, but the questions it raises about equity, creativity, responsibility, and impact are enduring. I truly believe it is our job to make sure that as the technology advances, our collective wisdom keeps pace. I want to extend my deepest thanks to our faculty co-directors, Professors Vivek Faris, who is here, and Tim Kraska, whose dedication and insights have helped shape MAGIC into a bold, collaborative initiative it is today. So let's thank them. I would also like to take a moment to thank the amazing staff of the MAGIC initiative, the MIT Schwarzman College of Computing, and the Office of Innovation and Strategy for their amazing contributions, not only for organizing this event, but the ongoing activity. So let's also give them a round of applause. It is now my deep honor to introduce President Sally Kornbluth. She has consistently championed the idea that MIT must not only respond to the rapid evolution of generative AI, but help shape its trajectory thoughtfully, ethically, and in service to the nation and the world. I'm deeply grateful for her leadership in establishing MGAIC as a presidential priority and for her continuous support for the initiative. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to MIT President Sally Kornbluth.
Thanks so much, Anantha, for the introduction. And I just have to say, today is Anantha's birthday, so this is a great, you know, birthday. He's been really outstanding in his leadership in bringing this consortium to life. So I guess in the context of MGAIC, that makes him the chief magician. So thank you. Let me also give a warm shout out to our other magicians here, our faculty co-directors, Anantha mentioned Vivek and Tim, and to the whole team of faculty and staff who organized today's program. So thanks to all. Also to the students, to the early career researchers, who will share their work in this afternoon's poster session. And I know that we're all looking forward to hearing from today's incredible speakers and panelists, starting with the legendary Jan LeCun. Today's symposium is the first of what I hope will be an annual flagship event for the MIT Generative AI Consortium. Now, you know, at MIT, one thing we do love is a great, as well as numbers, are great acronyms. Europe, MISTI, DAPR, DUSP. So we've now added, this is a little bit of sort of acronymical sleight of hand to call this MGAIC, MGAIC, but hopefully you'll forgive for that. Easy to remember, fun to say, et cetera. But I would argue that calling this effort MGAIC also points to something quite serious, why we're here together. You know, obviously in this audience, we've got some fans of the great scientific sci-fi master Arthur C. Clarke. So remember Clarke's third law. Any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from MGAIC. Now, I know I'm not the first, and I won't be the last, to connect Arthur Clarke's observation with the black box sensation of using generative AI. But put in your prompt, you get a polished answer back so fast, it actually feels like MGAIC. And of course, everyone here knows that generative AI does not work by MGAIC. And yet, even the experts, many of you, whom you'll hear from here, can't always explain how something does work. That makes Gen AI fundamentally different from really other technologies, and it creates a very important responsibility for an institution and a community like MIT. This audience includes experts, aspiring experts, on every part of the AI menu, and I'm certainly not one. But to explain the kind of responsibility I'm talking about, let me offer as an example something from my own field in the life sciences. My lab explored deep behavior of cancer cells, and today, when I talk to cancer researchers and clinician scientists on our faculty, they say that AI already touches and improves literally every aspect of their work, from how they design experiments and analyze data, to how they keep and manage records, to how they diagnose and care for their patients. They're positioned now to capitalize on a great many AI advances immediately. And I hear tremendous gratitude and enthusiasm. So part of MIT's responsibility is to keep those advances coming for the world. But those researchers and clinicians on their own are not in a position to address AI's risks and mysteries. How to guarantee accuracy and guard against hallucinations? How to get sufficient patient data to make the systems work while also preserving confidentiality? How to validate the results and achieve enough explicability that users feel safe to trust them? In short, how can you manage the MGAIC so that all of us can confidently rely on it for critical applications in the real world? And so they're counting on all of you, our faculty, our researchers, our students, together with our consortium members, to help. They're counting on you to tackle the whole suite of technical and ethical challenges whose solutions will allow society to make the most of this astounding technology. And in the myriad of other realms where AI is also changing everything, the rest of society is counting on you too. It's a big responsibility, but judging by the depth and breadth of interest on our campus, I have every confidence that we'll succeed. The excitement is everywhere. The two new undergraduate majors we've created in these fields were effectively sold out overnight. And when we announced our first round of MGAIC seed funding, we were stunned to receive more than 180 research proposals representing every school and the college. They covered an incredible range of ideas, from fundamental research to practical applications, from responsible deployment to workforce transformation. Many depend on collaborations across departments and disciplines, and crucially, collaborations with industry as well. So I want to close with a special nod to the consortium's founding members, as Anantha did, Analog Devices, Coca-Cola, InterSystems, OpenAI, SK Telecom, Tata, and TWG Global. What enables the MGAIC in the MGAIC Consortium is your commitment to explore very important AI challenges with us in the best open source tradition of MIT. We wouldn't be here today without you, and we're deeply grateful for your willingness to join us in that vital work. So thank you all for coming, and best wishes for a fascinating day. Thank you.